Hello friends, this is Samrat from Joyversity Overseas Education Private Limited, one of the leading overseas education consultants based in Goa. And we are back with you live on our Facebook page and our YouTube channel. This time we have Crandall University with us, and I have Mr. Rahul and Ms. Krati. Mr. Rahul is International Student Procurement Manager for Crandall University. And Ms. Krati is University Relation Manager. They will be telling us all the wonderful things about Crandall University and what Crandall University has to offer you. So without wasting much time, I'm passing on to Ms. Krati, who will introduce us to Crandall University. Ms. Krati, please.
Yeah, good evening, everyone. This is Krati representing Crandall University, New Brunswick, City of Moncton. As you know, Crandall is a destination of work and opportunities, and we are located in Canada. The Moncton City, which is located in eastern coastal area of Canada, which is the Atlantic province, you can say near Quebec, and right above New York City. And here is the presentation. This is our beautiful campus, 2-acre site campus in Moncton. And Crandall was founded in 1949, and since then we are running our services. Yes, 5 years ago we started our international procurement for our international students. So here's the presentation and some talk about the Crandall Crandall University, its courses and its goals. This is our team, Mr. Chris Robb, the Senior Director of Enrollment Manager, Mr. Tyler Steckley, the International Admissions Counselor, Mr. Denny Brown, the Dean of International Academic Program, and Mr. Rahul Messi, Manager of International Student Procurement India. So we are the team, me, Rahul, and we have more team members here in India. And the good part is this, Crandall has an admission office in India. And that's why we are offering the offer letters. Turnaround time is within 24 hours, you'll be getting your offer letters. If the IELTS pending, if your any provisional degrees are pending, but still you can apply for it. You can upload the documents via portal and you'll be getting the offer letters, conditional offer letters within 24 hours. Here are some information like why Canada, why Moncton, why Crandall, what are our ethos, and some important information about Crandall and campus. And then it's over to you, your FAQs. So why Canada? Everybody knows it's a quality education. It's a you know, well-known, recognized degrees over there. Our competitive tuition fees are there. And the Canada is overall very friendly and safe country. And nevertheless, yes, Canada has the 10th large economy of the world based on the GDP. So the education that government invest more on the education, cost of living, per capita income, and they are investing more on education institutes. So yes, that is why we do have a very strong economy, and with the strong economy, definitely the job options in Canada market, be it part-time or full-time, are plethora. So here exactly the Crandall is located. So if you know the Canada map, Crandall is located, as I mentioned you before, the East Coast area. And yes, we do have Greater Moncton International Airport. But it's not a direct flight from India. So that's why it's a 2-hour flight from Toronto, or you can come through Toronto or through Vancouver route. So it's centrally located. And here's the that red icon is mentioned. There's a Crandall University. And this is a 200-acre located area in Moncton. This is our Ministry of Immigration and Refugee and Citizenship for the Government of Canada Minister thought that New Brunswickers have their DNA, a welcoming spirit, and the understanding of the power of immigration to enhance the local community's economy and culture. So the sense of this thought is that we are very warm welcoming by our nature, And you know, we are multi-cuisine, multi-cultural. Small communities are living over there in Canada, especially in Moncton, if I talk about the New Brunswick province. And they are very welcoming spirit and multi-cuisine, multi-cuisine opt communities, and multicultural. Even if you talk about Crandall, right now we do have 26 country students within the campus, and they are all exchanging their gestures. They're exchanging, you know, good experience of life, and educating themselves, and you know, going for part-time, learning the new tactics of a business, getting the new experiences in within the Crandall pattern and you know, work culture. So this is all is the good part about. If you talk about Moncton, Moncton is, as I told you, is a hub city. And it is rightly centrally located and the full of industries and the financial sectors. So, and the population is, as per the 2016 census, is 1,08,000 citizenry only right now. And we do have an airport too, but it's not direct flight from India. And is a hub city of maritime, multi-cuisine restaurants, and the first bilingual province. So if you visit cic.gc.ca website, you'll be understanding this this part, that it is the government announced this first bilingual province is the New Brunswick. So as much as there's a French, as much as there's a English, and even we are working under you know, with Canadians and in Crandall University, Canada. And my all colleagues, they are very fluent and very good in English, and they, we don't find any difficulties while talking and while discussing and while making them understand about our, you know, any quote or any directions or anything we can talk about in English, and they are very good. And the major reason what I realized is that 1/5 of the Canadian are, were born in out of Canada. So this was the reason that they are very friendly with English language, and that's why French, I mean, any language is not a barrier for our international students. If you talk about the climate, so like India, we do have four seasons, spring, summer, fall, winter. Yes, we do have a very good spring when, you know, leaves changes their color. And summer is like 22 degrees Celsius, warm and breezy. Fall, definitely we do have snowfall. We do have heavy snowfall, no doubt in it. But the tenure of the snowfall is shorter. So it starts by December 1st week or sometime end of the November and ends by, you know, before April. And winter time indefinitely is -4 to -6, but it's good part that government and the local communities are completely, and Crandall itself, we do have a proper arrangement for heating system. So we do have a centralized heating system for our classroom, for our library, and wherever you're gonna reside it, on campus or off campus, we do have a proper heating system in every hostel, PGs and dormitories and other, you know, homestays options. Why Crandall? This is very important, that why Crandall? So we do have small class sizes. We are not entertaining more than 25 to 28 students over the one professor. And that's the reason it's very, the session, so it, by this way, session gonna be become more interactive and one-on-one. You can have a discussion with your fellows, with your faculties, and that after that, that you can actually exchange the knowledge. And Crandall University is affiliate, that we have a partnership. We do have an associate partner with Oxford University for exchange program for our undergrads. So one semester exchange program for a student who are doing undergrads is like a life-changing moment for them, no doubt. And whosoever, you know, experienced this, and I had a discussion with them afterwards, they share their thoughts and they share their experience once they, you know, come back from the Oxford. It's like a priceless moment and wow factors they found out. And as mentioned, you, the all communities are very warm and welcoming and friendly, and we don't, you don't find actually like other areas of or other countries of world like US, UK, Australia, some find of difficulties for white and brown, and some kind of a racism, some kind of a hesitation and irritation while your journey starts, and while you're studying, working, experiencing, and getting more gathering more information, gathering more knowledge towards the personal life and the professional life, both ways. So it's overall a very good combo of your emotions, of your personality, of your knowledge. And later on, definitely that's going to boost your career development, your personality development, and boost up your life too. We are offering some certificates, undergrads, and graduate programs. Offer certificates we are not providing for our international students. So in India and Asia level, we are only giving the offer letters and providing you the seats for the undergrads program and master's program. And we do have some kind of championship athletes like soccer, volleyball, basketball, cross country, boxing, and cricket. So, and we just don't have a cricket. Why I'm emphasizing cricket? Because we love cricket being Indian. So we just don't have cricket. We even won the provincial championship recently too. So we have cricket, and we do have a good level of cricket where you can actually win the trophies and experience more about the cricket, and it's beautiful and good game. Crandall University ethos. So Crandall University is a private Christian faith-based university, and which is open and accepting for all kind of background. Our master's program, again, is very versatile and very intense and advanced versions of, big-time management studies or MBA or global international studies program. So every kind of background person can opt these two masters. We do have two masters, so they can opt for any kind of work experience. They, if they belongs to a managerial work experience or degree, and if they're not, they both can apply for our masters. So it's very versatile. Our campus is completely alcohol, smoke, and drug free. Yes. Overall, I would say the overall city of Moncton is very peace and the completely a working culture. The people having a very working culture in it. They are very streamlined in their working pattern, their lifestyle. And yes, I would not say there is no crime, there's zero crime, no. But the crime rate are very minimal. Girls are really safe, because this is my personal experience being a woman. I can assure you this, that we don't find being a woman, being a girl, we don't find such difficulties to, enter and explore new opportunities in life or in your future states. So, and we do have a proper security guard system, and everything is completely for our students and focused on our students, so for their better development and their security. Focused on academic excellence and creating students who excel in their respective fields, yes, and very safe and welcoming community. Our touch wood, we really do have a strong and experienced faculty members. Our management are really strong and strict too at some level. So if you are looking for some extra, out of the curriculum activities or your academic, if you're looking for some off lecturing assistance, they are ready to provide you. They are available online. So these are the things are really, good part. And by this way, you guys can explore more. By this way, you can experience more, and by this way, you guys can get the knowledge about the new things. But because we understand it's completely a new thing, because you're leaving your food, faith, and family. Once you be in Canada, you're definitely missing these three things. So we are here to give you that platform. We are here to give you that space to enjoy, to understand, and to learn also in a better way. lots to talk about the quality education. Canada is famous for quality education as we are. So as I mentioned, you is very much Moncton, city of Moncton is very much industrial and full of financial sectors. So the problem, we don't find it for, you know, part-time jobs and full-time job availabilities. Because of the quality education, because we have a 60 to 70% is practical learning and 30 to 40% the theoretical learning. So that curriculum involves more industry visits, case studies, group presentations, personal presentations, and some kind of a workshop, industry related. So here you can actually experience the how you have to work at the time of on-the-job trainings, internships, and afterwards when you go for the full-time work opportunities. And we do have small class sizes, as I mentioned you. This is our definitely highlighted point that we don't entertain in a class to 25 to 28 students over the one professor. So it should be very one-on-one and interactive session, where you can explore your mind, where you can enhance your knowledge and your skills. Variety of programs and program length. We have a programs which is the proper length, and the duration of the programs is proper, and the credit hours is proper, and the content is proper. So where you can understand top to bottom the hierarchical management system and undergrads program. If you are just 12 pass out, just 18 years old, and how you have to enter into the new world, enter into the new kind of system. Because BBA, who have done the BBA here and who has doing the BBA in Canada, so that level of understanding and the education is different based on the India and Asia level. And the Canada is completely different. Their economics, their accounting, the teaching pattern is completely different. The content is very different. So there are some very attractive points where you have to look into that if you work, if you study here in the same topics, and if you study there in the same topics, there's a huge difference. And Crandall University is definitely here to bridge filling that exercise. So as easy access to post-graduation work permit, as you know that New Brunswick comes under the Atlantic province, and it is a government initiated program AIPP. Under this, you can apply for and explore the PR possibilities and get the PR within 6 to 8 months. Good part is that we understand that being a new in Canada, you need the assistance, and must be you if you are going for the master's. Ultimately, goal of your life is to get the PR, right? And after completing your graduation. So we do have a CIC immigrant desk within the campus in the university, where you can take the assistance submit your papers, and you can talk about the PR, explore the possibilities. New Brunswick has a variety of PNP to help the student immigrant. Growing job market in Moncton, as I mentioned you, is a completely industrial province, and the city of Moncton is a hub city, so definitely job is not a problem in Moncton. And good part is that we are only 108,000 citizenry, so we are looking for the workforce. And whatever program we have designed, especially masters, we designed under the supervision of provincial government officers. And like our one-year program, we condensed two-year masters into one-year program, and where we can have a workforce after their completion of graduation. We can talk about this in later. So here is the presentation part where I can show you the Crandall program. We do have undergrads program, Bachelor of Arts, which is a four-year program, Bachelor of Business Administration, which is a four-year program, Bachelor of Science, which is a four-year program. If you are a 12th pass and if you have a 60% and above, you can apply these bachelors. But if you have maths, then you can apply for a BBA and BSc. Without maths, because maths is mandatory, without maths, you can apply for BA. And we need IELTS 6.5 overall, not less than 6.0 in each category. Because of this COVID pandemic going on, we are accepting Duolingo, because lot many centers are partially open and closed. the IELTS center. So we are accepting Duolingo 120 scores overall, not less than 105. Mr. Rahul gonna talk about our master's program. Over to you, Rahul.
Rahul, we cannot hear you. You'll have to switch on your mic.
Good evening, Goa. Thank you, Samrat, for giving us this opportunity to share about Crandall. I'm going to add to a couple of things what Prati have shared. One of the things that she mentioned about is bilingual. When she mentioned that Moncton and New Brunswick is a bilingual state. In our campus, nobody speaks French. There's no French on campus. It's completely English. We all speak English. You will not find that people are speaking French, and you will not be able to understand. So don't get scared that you will be finding people speaking in French on campus. So that's one thing. And then the other thing that Kratiya mentioned, that immigration desk. We don't have such a specific desk on campus where you can just go and ask for immigration forms and get your immigration documents filled. I just wanted to make sure that you understand that, because a lot of students will misunderstand that. What Krati means is that time to time what happened is CIC, the immigration agency, send their representative to campus, and they come and they do a presentation on how to become a permanent resident of Canada. They do a presentation on that. So after graduation, what are the opportunities, what are the programs available in Canada where they can be qualified, and all the doubts they have, and they can clear those things. So that's two things that I have that I wanted to just clear those so that you don't have that misunderstanding. The other things that I also wanted to emphasize on is the job opportunities. So Canada have, New Brunswick have a lot of job opportunities at this point. If you compare those jobs out of Ontario, there are 58,000 jobs in Ontario, and there are only 7,000 jobs in Moncton. Now the difference between, now you'll see that there's 58,000 jobs and there's only 7,000, but I'll still look for 7,000 jobs, because those 7,000 jobs are skilled 7,000 jobs, and those 58,000 jobs are only cashiers and working at the gas station jobs. So that's the difference that you will find. That there are low paid jobs in Ontario, and there is almost none high skilled jobs in Ontario, and there is a lot of high skilled jobs available in New Brunswick, and there is more opportunities for you to be able to become an immigrant in New Brunswick than any other province faster. This is the information that we are giving you from the website called cic.gc.ca or canada.ca. So this information that we are giving you is out of our government website. It's not our words. We are not making this up for you. All this information you can find at cic.gc.ca. So if we made a mistake, don't take our word for it. Go to this website called cic.gc.ca. Now, coming back to our programs for master's level, these are the two programs that is more successful program, and most of our Indian students take these programs for immigration purposes. Our first program is Masters of Organizational Management. That's our one-year program, which is condensed into, it's basically designed, it's a two-year program, but it's condensed into one-year program. There are three semesters to it, there are three semesters, as I said, and there's no break in between. The tuition cost of this program is 24950. That's the tuition cost. And after graduation, you can get a postgraduate work permit for up to 1 year or more on this. We have some students who got more than that, but that is what they are getting. There's a lot of job opportunities on this particular program, because the focus on this program is management, human resource, and operations. Those are the major high skill jobs available in New Brunswick. And those are the B category jobs in on Canadian North Coast also. Then the second program that we have is called Masters of Management, which is our two-year program. This is our very recent program that we have designed because we have a lot of demand where people wanted a two-year program because they also wanted a three-year postgraduate work permit. And we recently designed this program and it's very successful for us. And there are four semesters to it, and there's last internship is our paid internship. So the first three semesters, where it's an in campus internship, and last semester will be internship. The total program cost will be $32,000, and the last semester will be internship, which will be an option for a student if they have a family or relative in India and have a business. They can approach our relevant department to see if they can do that internship with their family. These tuition fees that I have mentioned, they are included, all the fees including books and everything. The entry requirement for this program is 6.5, not less than 6.0 for IELTS, and 120, not less than 105 for Duolingo. We are very specific on their graduation. They have to have 60%. We don't accept anybody who's less than that. So over to you, Prati.
Yes. So I'm just adding up more points here for MOrgam and MM, which we call Master of Management. MOrgam, we need resume, LOR, two letter of references, and SOP. And why we need LOR? Because we need a experienced person. So because it's the adult learning, it's an advanced and enhanced program of management. And MM can be applied for fresher and by freshers or the experienced one, whosoever looking for 2 years master's. So MOrgam is a 1 year program. MM Master of Management is a 2 year program, which can be applied by freshers or experienced. But MOrgam, a Master of Organizational Management, only can apply whosoever has a 3 year or 2 year plus experience in their respective professional field.
One more minute I can take here, please. So all the audience who are watching us live on Facebook and YouTube, if you have any questions simultaneously, start typing in the comment box so we can read them here and we can answer them as the presentation is going on. So please start typing your questions. Over to you, Krati.
Yeah. And our undergrads program and for masters, we need 60 and above percentage academically, and we need IELTS 6.5, not less than 6.0 in each category. If in any band you have 5.5, we will not accept you. And overall 6.5, not less than 6.0 with ELA application will be accepted. There are some goodies service with Crandall, where we're gonna provide you. We do have a free airport pickup for arriving students. What you have to do, your counselor or your agent has to inform us prior that my student date of flight is this, and the person gonna reach over there and this on this date, and my Crandall staff will be there to receive you. We do have orientation and information sessions. So once you guys got the visa, you have to inform your agent, which is Joyversity Education Service. And simultaneously, we will get to know that how many applications, how visas you have it. And accordingly, we do organize a pre-orientation session. Normally, we interact, we interact with your family, because this time, this is the very first time you're gonna introduce us as an, a Crandall representative. Your family will understand that my son or my daughter is going to ahead with this institute with these guys. So it's like a very much interactive and one-on-one session kind of, and very essential part when you are about to leave India for a couple of years and your family is in doubt or maybe going through an emotion that is going on and on. So that's why where we came into the picture, and we discussed personally to one-on-one your parents with your students and your counselor too, that who has initiated your application, your visa. So these are the things why this pre-orientation is important. First is family interaction is important. Second, that lot of things you have no idea about the immigration formalities, how you have to fill up a form, how you have to who are your fellows now, because you'll be there with them for next couple of years. So who are going along with you, you're gonna meet in campus, who belongs to India or especially Goa. So these are the things. Also, it's a complete Crandall tour where you can interact with the Dean of International Academics. They come live. We do have student ambassador. So at the time of, once you reach campus, you know that this is the person, if I find any problem, this is my point of contact and I have to get in touch with him or them, or these are the numbers, or these are the counters where I can go and talk about it. And yes, we do have some Canadian SIMs as well. So if you're looking for some Canadian SIMs, we can provide you with $10 credit. So by this way, you can get connected with us, with your family, with your friends while traveling. Once you landed on campus or a mountain, you are connected. Sometimes you missed your connecting flight, how you have to catch up, and at that point of time, how you can get associated with us, how you can get communicated with us. So these are the small things where we can give you the complete information as per our experiences. General assistance and access to service to students, which comes under the pre-orientation session program. Student successes, we do have some student successes, club, peer coaches, mentor fellow students, and provide family-friendly assistance. Support and guidance, as I mentioned, you, Dean of International Academic Program, and we do have a cultural celebration. So definitely, we are not celebrating Holi Diwali, but yes, the color of festival, the light festival, the Christmas, the New Year. So because we do have a, different country representative on campus, 26 country students right now studying togetherly on campus. So we do have a different kind of cultures, we exchanging emotions, and we exchanging great vibrations, great positive thoughts, which gives you the, enlightening your growth in your professionally and personally, and enhance your knowledge too. As I mentioned you, we do have campus life at Crandall. So we do have some associate and societies like Crandall Student Association, Graduate Students Society, Faith and Services we do have. We do have sports club, student ambassador group, where you can get connected. Again, as I mentioned you early in the my presentation, we founded in 1949. So we are very much grounded and traditional by our roots, by our culture, by our tradition, but we are very much advanced by our infrastructure, by our teaching pattern and our culture and system. So we are very modern and friendly campus, which is completely a drug, smoke and alcohol free. We do have library, cafeteria, gym, accommodation we do have on campus and off campus both. So according to your preference, and once you got the visa, and once at the time of pre-orientation, we're going to provide you this information that accommodation wise, where you have to go on campus or off campus, and we can talk about that. But we do have both kind of options. We do have off campus some arrangement again for the Canadian, with the Canadian families or some Indian families, where you can have a home stay with them according to your preferences. Apart from the IELTS, we do have another English language proficiency test. We do accept it at a university level, that is TOEFL. paper-based is 580. You guys can mention this. Please jot down these points. This is very important information. So IELTS 6.5, not less than 6.0. TOEFL paper-based 580, computer-based 236, internet-based 90. CAEL, we are accepting 70. MELAB, we are accepting 85. PTE also, we are accepting 58 to 65, which is equivalent to 6.5 IELTS. And now, because of this COVID issue, we are accepting Duolingo. So here's the Duolingo format. Listening, reading, writing, speaking. Overall, they are taking care of all the, all the aspects. And minimum, we need 105. Maximum, we are requiring, overall, we are requiring 120. So how to apply Crandall? How to apply Crandall? Of course, you have to be in touch with Joyversity Education Service and me, and interact and be in touch with Mr. Samrat. And I'm really congratulating Samrat and team and entire team of Joyversity Goa, who has initiated this platform and who has given this opportunity to us. We are sharing our thoughts, we are sharing our experiences, and we are delivering our information about Crandall and its courses. So you have to apply online. Please visit Joyversity Goa and submit your set of documents, either your IELTS or any degrees are pending. Still, you can apply for it and you will get the conditional offer letter within 24 hours. Once you submit your pending documents and your yearly fees and application fees, you can get the letter of acceptance within 7 to 10 working days. We do have three intakes, January, May, and September. September, we recently closed very successfully. Now we are open for January 2021 for undergrads and masters, and May, we are open for only masters. As the basic requirement, the eligibility criteria at a university level is 60% and above. In any background, we are accepting masters. Any 3-year or 4-year degrees we are accepting. Any open universities like Manipal, IGNU, we are accepting. And year of gap we are accepting, which has to be justified by your work experience. Any age person can apply. There is no age barrier. Any person who's plus 30, plus 40, plus 45, they can go for a master's program with us. And they're eligible for PGWP, and of course they can explore the PR possibilities. Why we are very strict and limited to talk about the immigrant questionnaire, because I hope you're gonna mention about the PR in your chat box. Because we are the university staff and representatives, so we can talk about Crandall and its courses and their peripheral aspects. But the best way to explore the PR possibilities domain-wise, the province-wise, you can always go and visit www.cic.gc.ca. And definitely, Samrat is very good in it. Joyversity team is good in it. So you can take the visa counseling part and the this part you can discuss and taken care by the Joyversity Education Goa. The payment mode, we are accepting paymytuition.com. So you have to just log in paymytuition.com, select Crandall University, and you can submit your application fees, which is $500. And once you receive the payment acknowledgement receipt, you can share with us and we can process your application for the letter of acceptance. You can be in touch with india@crandallu.ca. So for any questions, you can put up here. But the best way to, dialogues and conversations, you can have a chat with Mr. Samrat and team, Joyversity Goa. This is some job opportunities at Crandall. That on-campus work opportunities are available, depends on your academic and potential and how much you are good in it. But we do have on-campus work opportunities too, and off-campus also employment is available local in Moncton. As I mentioned you, it's a full of industries over there. This is the latest job fair post. So you can find here the variety of careers, which is like in the banking sector, hotels, hotel industry, HR, marketing, sales, logistics, some IT sector. So I can highlight you more here. It's like RBC, you can see left corner, extreme corner, and right corner, TD Canada. So these are the two banking sectors which are, you know, empaneled, and they are recruiting from us. So the good part is that province, that New Brunswick province government runs the job fair not once or twice, 3 to 4 times in a year. Like every after semester, you can consider this. So there are job fairs going on and on, and where we are also a part of it, and where our international students and everybody involved in it. And we basically, it's a platform which government initiated, and they are giving you all the international immigrants that platform where you can get interacted and be in touch with your relative and respective field. And because we understand you are new in Canada, you'll be new in Canada, and you have no contacts, no connects, so how will you get in touch with the industry level? So this is the way we can provide you that platform where you can interact with at a provincial level employers.
I'm going to add a little bit more here. If you go to the previous slide, there is TD Canada Trust, RBC Tangerine, if you see on the top orange color logo here, the co-op on the bottom, and these are the financial institutes. There's a lot of financial institutes moved to in New Brunswick. The reason they moved to New Brunswick is because the real estate is very cheap, and the labor is really cheap also. So the head of operations or their call centers they're moving there, and that's why the employment rate is really high. Now there are these concentric, if you see here, this is a call center that we also have it in India. And this is a very huge call center in India. It used to be called something else here in India. They have a huge contract with Microsoft here, and now they Microsoft and other Xbox and everything, that's what they support in India, and basic not in India, but they hired people in India, and they support the US, Australia, New Zealand, and other parts of the world, and they have a call center in New Brunswick also. We have a health sectors also, Blue Cross and Me Davis. So that sector is also huge there. And then there's companies here that is not listed, is called Tech Mahindra, which is an Indian company, and HCL. Those two companies are based there also. So there are huge opportunities in New Brunswick.
Can I ask a question here, Rahul?
Yes.
Is there what kind of pay packages do students get after passing out from the university? Like in all these companies, is there any standard wage or something like that?
It all depends on the ability of the student. And I can give you an example. It's not my graduate student, but it's my personal people who used to work for me when I was in Alberta. And I had three students from Ontario who were working with me in my business. And they were same graduates, and they were three different level of people. And three level of people in the sense that there are three level of, how can I put this? Three level of, like one of them was really hardworking. I'm not gonna say it in, you know, I'm gonna be really nice. I'm gonna put it in a nicer way. So one was really very hardworking. One was a little bit lazy, and the last one was very lazy. So the first one got a job in a very nice food chain in Alberta, and was making $40 an hour. And then the second one got $25 an hour, and then the last one got a minimum wage. So that's how it is. So it all depends on your ability. So the more harder you work, the harder you get paid. And then right now he's making $125 an hour, the harder working guy. So it's all depends on the ability of how you do.
Right. Another question which every student would like to ask here is, while studying, what kind of wages they can earn? Like,
minimum
wage. To cover,
yeah, minimum $12.35.
Oh, wow, that's great. So the entire living cost can be covered within this.
More
like, I think they are allowed to work 20 hours a week.
20 hours a week. Yes.
Okay. One more thing I would like to tell students, something about postgraduate work permit. This is an arrangement which Canadian government has made for all the students, that once you complete a program of 1 year duration in Canada, you are entitled to get a postgraduate work permit of 1 year. And if you complete a program of 2 years, then you are entitled to get a postgraduate work permit of 3 years, up to 3 years. Which means that you don't have to leave the country immediately. You will be allowed to stay back in Canada and start working and start earning there in Canada. So this is one wonderful program. So in Crandall University, you have two master's program and so many bachelor's program, which are again entitled to get these postgraduate work permits.
I have a correction. The minimum wage is $11.70.
Okay, that's great.
I'm gonna add one point here for couples, for spouse or dependent visas. So it is also a great opportunity in Canada because it's a dependent visa. It will get it, and it's an open work permit for a dependent.
Yes, and then again, we are not the one who will advise any visa counseling, so you have to contact Samrat and visit the cic.gc.ca for more information.
Yes, of course, we at Joyversity, right since the beginning, like right from making your application until your visa, we are there with you. We will do your visa application for you on your behalf, and we will be guiding you at every stage of your journey. And yeah, a few more questions for you. What kind of accommodations are available in and around campus?
So we do have on-campus accommodation, which will cost you for the academic year, which is not including summer, around $12,000, $11,000 to $12,000 for single occupancy. And then if a student wants to live off campus, that will be around $450 to $500 a month.
Wow, that's great. So off campus is kind of cost effective.
That is correct.
Yeah. And is there any limitations to seats or availability?
Yes. So our intakes, like for September intake, we already closed in June 10th for September intake. So our January intake will be fairly, it will be closed soon also. Depends on the availability of our seats. So I will recommend that a student can apply as soon as possible. I am looking at closing the intake by the end of second week of August, so or 15th of August. So our January intake would be closed. So if you can apply for January intake before that.
That is kind of very early, Mr. Rahul. But the problem right now, because of this COVID, many of the Goan students, the final year graduate students, they have not given their exams, final exams right now. So let's hope by then we should get their results.
So I'm talking about master's students, so, but bachelor's still will be open.
Right, right. And another question, you give kind of conditional offers as well. Like if the students have not received their offer, are they getting conditional offers?
That is correct.
And is there any application fee involved?
There is no application fees if we are issuing conditional offer letters. So once the student decided that they wanted to go ahead with it, then to secure the seat, they have to pay the application fees, and then we secure their seat.
Wow, this is so wonderful. Like the student can first apply, and when the student has conditional offer, that is when he has to pay the application. Unlike the other universities, that first you have to pay the application fee and then you get the offer or something. So and this is a very wonderful initiative from your university. Thank you.
And our responses are very, very prompt, if you see. Yes. That time is really short.
Yes. And then
another question would be like, what is the turnaround time? Like after application, in what duration do you get back to the student?
24 hours.
Wow, that's commendable.
Yes. Amazing. And then if a student have a WES report, then there is no application fees.
Oh, wow. That's great.
So if the student have WES done already, then there is no application fees.
Okay. But WES is kind of a long process. So maybe...
this is what I'm saying. Yeah. If the student already have done WES, then there is no application. But if that's something, there are some students who already have, like mature students who went through the process of applying for their immigration beforehand and applying for their master's, is an opportunity for them to apply for this program and get a application fee waiver through that.
Great.
So if they have, yes, then no problem. We have, it's waiver completely application fees, but if they don't have, definitely we do have our own evaluation team, and that's why their application fees takes place. And here, once you got the conditional offer letter, once you confirm and mail back that, yes, we are going ahead with the process with your this intake and this program, and then he can pay the application fees via paymytuition.com and submit the payment acknowledgement receipt with us that I have paid it. And on the basis of that, we're going to process their letter of acceptance within 7 to 8 working days, sometimes 7 to 10 working days.
Okay, great. So most of the universities, actually, what they have said is that they will be accepting Duolingo test score only for the September intake, and for January they will be accepting only IELTS or TOEFL. So is it the same with Crandall as well?
We have decided to accept students for Duolingo for January also, because we are closing our January intake sooner because of the limited seats. So we will accept a student with Duolingo at this point.
Oh, that's great. So yes. Students will have a chance to, because IELTS exam are not happening in Goa since March. And yes. It's not likely that they will have it till August as well.
Yeah, so they can apply, they can take Duolingo or IELTS indicator.
Okay, that's great.
The IELTS online test. So IELTS online and offline both are accepting, and Duolingo online.
Okay, great.
At a university level, definitely we are accepting IELTS indicator, which is online, and Duolingo. But you see the probability of at the time of visa applying, Samrat.
Yes. One most important question. I know we are not immigration consultants and we are not supposed to say anything about immigration, but when it comes to going abroad and studying, most of the students actually intend to settle down and work there. So how is it as compared to other provinces in New Brunswick? How easy it is to get permanent residency?
I think for that, you need to go to the cic.gc.ca website and get your answer. I am not the right person to answer that.
Okay, no problem.
Overall, province or a city of Moncton, I can talk about it. That cost of living is cheaper. The job accessibilities are easy. Crandall staff and management is really supportive for on-campus and off-campus job availabilities. And accommodation options, and definitely with the help of local surrounding, you can get to know about the PR possibilities. But again, the good way is cic.gc.ca.
Okay, thank you very much. So students, as you can see, you have a plethora of options. Ms. Krati and Mr. Rahul, they have explained you so well about each and every aspects of going to Crandall University. Let's hope that you will take your decision soon. You'll get in touch with us for all the information. We have it at our office in Margao and Panjim as well. So thank you very much, Mr. Rahul and Krati, for sharing all the information about Crandall University. And I'm closing this session now.
Thank you.
Thank you, Samrat. Thank you so much for inviting us, having us here. And all the best. Stay safe, Goa. Signing off.
Yeah, thank you.